Hi, I'd like to tell you about Google Cloud Identity and Access Management. I'll call it Cloud IAM, or IAM for short. Cloud IAM is Google Cloud Platform's unified system for managing access to resources and assigning permissions for users and services to access those resources. Cloud IAM is designed for organizations with many individual projects and users. The idea is to unify control for access for all of these projects and their resources in one place, making it easier for one organization to keep track of everything they've got going on in Google Cloud Platform.
IAM is built on a concept called a policy. Policies answer the question, who can do what to which thing? They are made up of permissions which grant access to resources that are bundled into roles which are assigned to identities. The combination of identity, role, permission, and resource determine if a given action is allowed by IAM. In order to further understand IAM, we need to go into more depth on identities, resources, permissions, and roles.
Identity is all about defining the who part of an IAM policy.
Individual people have Google accounts that can be used as an identity in IAM. Surface accounts, which are used for one service to connect to another without human intervention, are another type of identity. Both of these types of accounts have a username and some sort of credential. Both of these accounts can be placed into Google Groups, which can be used to simplify assigning permissions to resources. You can also use a Google app domain as you would a group to give permission to a resource to all users in a given organization.
Resources are the various components of Google Cloud Platform to which you can control access.
Resources include things like cloud platform projects, cloud storage buckets, and pubsub topics. Check the documentation for which resources are available to use with IAM at the current time.
In IAM, permissions take the form of service, resource, verb.
So if I wanted to grant an identity the right to listen to a topic in pubsub, the correct permission would be pubsub topic list. If instead I wanted to grant the ability to write a file to a bucket in cloud storage, I would apply storage bucket create. Check the documentation for the service in question as to what the various permissions are.
Roles are to permissions as groups are for identities. They allow you to bundle up a set of logically connected permissions in a common way and then add them to a policy.
If you are a Google Cloud Platform veteran, then you are familiar with what we are now calling primitive roles: owner, editor, and viewer. These roles work exactly the same way they always have, but in many cases they can result in being more permissive than you want to be. For example, under this model, an editor in a given project can add VMs in Compute Engine and delete storage buckets in Cloud Storage. This may be suboptimal for your purposes.
That's why we've added curated roles. These curated roles are tied to resources and allow for a resource-centric assigning of access rights.
For example, someone with the role App Engine Admin has the equivalent of a broad array of individual permissions that allow them to administer a project's entire App Engine configuration. However, someone with App Engine Deployer can only add code and push that code to production. They could not modify the daily quota for App Engine. Furthermore, neither of these users could modify anything to do with Compute Engine.
Not unless someone had given them access to Compute Engine separately with Compute Engine roles.
As you can see, policies are made up of roles, which are made up of permissions, which are assigned to resources. We add groups or users to that policy, and through that policy, they gain access to the specific resources their roles give them.
The last concept you should know is hierarchy.
Basically, policies flow from the top, an organization, down to projects, and finally to resources, which means that you can decide organization-wide policies, which can then be augmented by policies that you set on a particular project, which can further be added to by policies you set on a resource. So you can assign access to individual resources, or you can go higher and apply them to an entire project, or even higher and assign them to an entire organization, which will then apply to all projects in that organization, and those policies will cascade down to resources in those projects, meaning you can be as permissive or as locked down as you like.
And that's the basics of Cloud IAM. You can find out more at our documentation website, and we can't wait to find out what you're going to build next with Cloud IAM.